guests. Skyhook!
As soon as I saw that band, I knew they were something special. One of the great bands that we discovered was the Hunters and Collectors.
So Michael, the big G, took this little scrawny girl from Melbourne to the world. And back home again.
But while Mushroom was taking our artists to the world, it was bringing the world to our shores, where Aussie crowds would welcome the biggest stars on the planet.
I don't know how to interview you because it starts with this biog, who is Madonna?
You just have to work harder because there's always going to be someone that wants it more than you.
I do have CDs on sale and they do pay for my food.
Ginger hair. Really short.
He stutters. That guy doesn't become a pop star.
You'd feel he's in the building, he's somewhere.
Bam, he blasts through the fucking door. We're going to make you a star, kid.
It's so unlikely.
He's always looking for something that somebody hasn't heard yet.
He had the energy of a rock drummer.
Matt! Michael Kaninsky, how are you?
60s radio had hardly any Australian content. I couldn't understand why people weren't supporting their own war. That's why Mushroom started.
The whole evolution of Australian music is about to erupt.
The first few years of Mushroom, there was a crazy risk.
People said, oh, this isn't going to work. If he had faith in it, the more it drove him.
He has been so influential in an entire continent's music scene.
I imagine being a rock promoter as the biggest fucking nightmare. There has to be a reason why he did it.
Hello, my name is Michael Morley, and I'm here to review Ego, the Michael Gudinski story. Now, this is about a guy who is a record, like a producer who does promoting for some of the most, name any name out there, he's done it. He is known for creating the historic Mushroom Records here in Australia, which was the one and only thing that makes international artists come here to do touring. Name them. Foo Fighters, Taylor Swift, Ed Sheeran, Elton John, Paul McCartney, Sting. Names are everywhere. I could list a whole heap of them. He even signed Kylie Minogue. He even, when Split Enz were going through a start and they lost their main singer, he was the one to bring in Neil Finn. Said, bring in Neil. And he and that band became legendary. And then not to mention, they also changed the name and became a different band, and it was called Crowded House. So he was involved in a lot of things. He had revolutionized, not like just international music, he revolutionized Australian music, Australian singers, and New Zealand singers. He also, back in 2011, there was this Ranga kid that was singing at bars, singing at, you know, local, you know, inland areas that anyone could just go up and do a local singing, just, you know, anyone could do it. And he was also sleeping on the streets. He saw the kid and said, this guy's good. Why is he sleeping on the streets? And why is he performing just in local pubs? He invited him to the house. He, you know, invited him to have dinner. He signed him. He basically was a surrogate father. And that kid
is Ed Sheeran. And it's amazing how much this guy has done for these artists. He even before when Kylie Minogue, when she first started, he got her signed and got her, you know, recognized internationally. He even made Sting, after he left the Police band, he became his own thing. And, you know, it was really him that made him successful. It's amazing when I watch this that we always look at the artist and go, they're who they are. For some reason, we always know them and we're crazy for them, but we always forget about the people behind the scenes that made it happen or made them become who they are. And you might not know the name Michael Gudinski, but you would know that any touring poster that you see is Mushroom Records that is promoting it, that they are the ones that do every tour here in Australia. Okay, anyone that's coming up that we got, we had Ed Sheeran come here at the start of the year. That was Mushroom Records. We had, we're going to have Matchbox 20. We had the Backstreet Boys. We are going to have Taylor Swift come up early next year. We're going to have, you know, Paul McCartney. All Mushroom Records. Every single one is Mushroom Records. Insane. It's insane to know that this Australian is so revolutionary and I had never heard of him. And not to mention he had an interesting backstory. I mean, I'm not going to talk too much about it, but his sister got caught by the Nazis. you know, he also passed away. He had heart disease. It's a very tragic but very revolutionary story. I mean, he helped so many people. He literally was the forefront of most of these artists' success. The only thing I didn't know was that I had no idea who he was, and now I'm like, how the hell? I mean, it just shows you could go anywhere, perform somewhere, and there might be some guy who nobody knows that could be the most important bloke that would help your career and make you a star. That's who Michael Gudinski was. He was that guy that was anonymous that had the connections. He knew people. He was running one of the most successful touring promotion, you know, for bands in Australia. No one had ever done that. No one in Australia had ever done any of that. And he was the first one to say, well, we love music. Why isn't Australia getting promotions? Why isn't Australia doing anything with music? You know, and it's true. And if it weren't for him, we wouldn't have Countdown with Molly Meldrum. We wouldn't even have Molly Meldrum, probably wouldn't have existed if it weren't for Mushroom Records. There's lots of things that Michael Gudinski has done that revolutionized Australia. Yeah, I was absolutely blown away by this documentary. 10 out of 10. It's a great one. I couldn't really fault it. You know, I was like, wow, what is this guy not done?
When I get obsessed, I don't like losing.
He came on strong, you know.
His strength was his ability to connect with artists.
Gudinski, where are you?
Yes!
Long live Australian rock and roll, thank you.
Here we go.